fellow came all the way from Van Horn. They are surely a different breed than you.
Evening.
No reason to break your own back.
What a girl you're becoming.
My business is taken care of. Can I help you?
I hope so. I want a loan, sir. A line of credit, so I can buy some property.
What property?
An old ranch, Beecher's Hope.
Oh, that old dump?
I know it ain't much, but I ain't much of a farmer either. But I will get there.
That is a very unusual way of asking for a loan. Mr.
Marston.
Marston.
Only folk around here call me Milton. It's kind of a joke, I guess.
A joke, huh? Which folk?
Mr. Geddes. Uh-huh. I work for him. He said that you could help me out. I mean, if you can.
So old David Geddes told you I'm the kind of man to loan a man with two names money so he can buy a rundown farm on account of his lack of farming skills, huh?
Don't sound too promising when you put it like that.
Well, how would you put it?
Sorry to waste your time, sir.
Oh, sit down. I'm sure we can figure something out. Now, of course, we'll be expecting you to make regular payments, and given a lack of much evidence you got any means of repaying, the terms won't be too great. But if my cousin vouches for you, it'll be okay with the bank.
Really?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, of course, we'll be expecting our money back regular as clockwork until the debt's settled. Otherwise, the farm reverts to the bank, no matter how much you paid.
I understand.
All right. Well, why don't you go check out the land while I fix the contracts and talk to Mr. Geddes. Oh, I heard there's squatters up there. We've been having so many problems recently, they'll need clearing on.
Sure.
Well, come back when you're done and we'll fix up the paperwork.
I'm back, girl.
Is not old Crazy Man Cassidy. Seek redemption, all. It's never too late. Help a blind man.
Here you go.
You're a fool, fiend. But not so much of a fool as you think, nor such a fiend. The past is done, and the future yet to come.
Okay, I guess I'll bear that in mind.
Can I help you, friend?
I hope so. Who's in charge here?
No one, mister. This is a free country.
Now that I ain't so sure about. Listen, I'm buying this land. I'm afraid you guys are gonna have to go somewhere else.
Who's this?
I ain't sure. Some fancy Dane city boy says he owns this land. Or he's gonna.
Owns it?
That's what he says.
Okay. And how come we living here?
I ain't sure.
Look. Take some money. Go try and find somewhere else to stay.
You for real, friend?
Sure, take it.
You're a real gentleman. Okay, boys, let's go celebrate.
Thanks, mister.
Ah, it's you, the man with two names and no past. Come on in. How'd you make out?
Well, let's just say there are no more squatters.
Okay. Well, I got your paperwork ready. Now, you sure about buying this place? It's really run down, and the price isn't too great.
I think it would mean a lot for my wife. At least mean I was listening to her.
Okay. Well, sign here and here. Now we own you, Mr. Marston, and we own Mr. Milton, too, and we own your property. But you can buy your freedom each week. Eventually, you will be a homeowner.
I understand.
Congratulations, you are now a real American, indebted and owned by the bank. I'm joking. They own me. They just own your property. Now, you can also use this line of credit for any home improvements you need to make, of course.
I can?
Sure. Be good, Mr. Marston. Welcome to home ownership. It's a beautiful thing. Let your wife know what to complain about. I'm just joking.
Well, it is you. Well, I never. I thought you was dead, boy. Dead.
Uncle?
The very same. Come here. I saw you going into the bank, and by the looks of things, you ain't robbed it.
I've gone straight.
Bull crap.
No, for real. Well, I'm trying.
All these years, you ain't changed a bit. Maybe a little bit. I thought you was dead.
Not yet. Well, I got some things to take care of.
No, not a problem. I'll come too.
No, you don't have to.
No, I'm real sick, John. Lumbago. It's a slow and painful death, my brother.
Evidently.
Have a little pity, will you? Huh?
Come on, then.
All right. You gonna mount?
Follow me.
Yeah.
we hit it?
West.
West? Oh, God, ain't you a man of few words? I can see we're headed west. You know, speaking in monosyllables don't make you seem interesting. It makes you seem stupid.
I don't care how I sing.
Well, now where west are we headed, you damn grunting fool?
This ranch I bought just now.
Is that what you were doing in the bank? Spending all your money? Oh, I own a ranch in the armpit of West Elizabeth. Oh, my lord.
Not that that's any of your concern, but I was in the bank borrowing the money.
Well, that's even worse. Yeah, you can run from a bounty, John. You can't run from a bank. Is Abigail there?
No. She's, her and Jack are waiting until I'm set up before joining me out here.
You mean she left you? Oh, I never thought she was a smart woman, but, you know, this makes me think maybe I was wrong.
No more of that. I just bought this place, and you're lucky I'm showing it to you and not looking for a place to bury you out here. Look at her.
Okay.
What do you think?
Why exactly did you buy this dump?
For Abigail?
Why? Is she an idiot?
No.
What were you thinking?
I don't know. She said she wanted it.
She ever seen it? What are we gonna farm here? Rocks?
We?
You don't have a hope here without a wise hand at the tiller.
Enough of that. Get out of here. On your way.
No, you're stuck with me. Seems I'm stuck with you. John, the rock farmer.
So, you think I'm an idiot?
No. I know you're an idiot.